republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Our motion to the meeting.
I so move.
Second.
Okay, first and second. Everybody in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carries. Open Meetings Act rules are posted on the door back there if you're interested in reading those. Roll call, Jason.
Here.
Krista.
Here.
Jan.
Here.
Mike.
Here.
Vicki.
Here.
And myself here. Now approve the agenda, consent agenda. We're waiting for that 1 month of bills to hit us.
The big one?
Yeah.
The tsunami of
bills. Okay, here's our agenda and minutes for the financials. Anything on the reports or the claims?
I'm good with claims. Two outstanding.
Okay, if everybody's all right with that, we'll take a motion to approve the agenda, consent agenda.
Make a motion to approve the consent agenda as reported.
Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, nay. Motion carries. Okay, we're at public comment. Is anybody going to have public comment? I'm not going to read this if we don't have anybody who wants to talk. Okay, let's skip that. I'm not gonna waste all that. Okay, now we're gonna move to number 9. We're gonna move around here a little bit because we've got, Dr. Alt's got some place to go, so we're gonna try and shorten this up for him a little bit. So we're gonna jump around on the agenda. We're gonna move to number 9 up to number 8. And so we'll go ahead and discuss. Action on resolution authorization and issuance of certificates of participation from Americas Investment Corporation for the Summer Elementary Project. I don't know if you guys have any more before we get started. You sent us an update of what we wanted. Interest rates changed?
Not much. You know, they've been bumping up and then going down depending on, you know, what the latest news is. We're basically here just to answer questions if you have them.
Everybody who found that paper highlighted. We had a budget committee meeting. Our committee got together and took a look at this a little bit with the budget right before this. Kind of talked over what we thought, and we don't think there's probably any problem coming up with the $750,000 down. We don't really know that we want to stretch it to $1 million. We probably could, but just don't know that we want to go that far. We looked at our depreciation fund, which we have
515
in, and we haven't really done much with that for ever. So we're talking about or recommending or whatever, taking about 400,000 out of there, and then the 350 out of the building fund to get our 750,000. And then I think we're all right with the 3-year plan, the 6 cents. That will still leave us money to operate over and above if something comes up with the figures you had. So.
Yeah, each penny is about 70 grand, so we're right at 7 cents right now in our building fund for 2 years in a row. So if we maintain that level, we'll be able to pay the note each of 3 years, plus have about 70,000 in additional income into the building fund.
And we will still have $100-some thousand in that building, depreciation fund that we could tap into yet, so. And I guess, you know, when we get to the end of this 3 years, that's what we do approve. We get to the end of it, we wanna spend a year to build that depreciation back up. And put it on the board, what the board wants to do at that time. I personally, I just don't see letting that money sit in there. We get $40 a month in interest. Okay, what can we save by not paying interest and using, you know? So how long's it been at $500,000 in there since you've been on the board? I mean, it just sits there, so. So that's kinda what we came up with. I don't know if you three have any more questions or if you, something scares you or wanna be more aggressive.
Committee's recommendation.
I am too.
Alrighty, you guys have comments about going that route? Good, bad, indifferent, don't really care?
3 years, we'll have the payments, if it's alright with the school board and Dr. Alt, is we'll have your principal payments coming due probably June, and then interest only in December. Now, we can flip those around, but instead of doing a 3-year financing, then it would be 3.5 years.
If we flip it.
If it's alright with you, we'll just, so our first principal would be June of 2019, 20, and 21, and June of 21, it would be paid off.
Okay. So it'd be slightly above, or slightly longer than 3 years, but by a couple months.
Keep in mind, by doing that, you're only receiving first half taxes. You're not receiving that second half. So if you still have some left over in your building fund, you could possibly, if you have to, borrow some for that, and then when it comes in September, you just pay it back.
It wouldn't change total P and I?
No. Actually, your interest rates in June are gonna be lower than your interest rates in December.
A little bit lower. It's not gonna be a giant drastic difference, but it will be a little bit lower.
It'd be like 0.05% difference between June and December of the two halves. And on $1.2 million, that would add up. Give you an idea. It's about $5,000 or $6,000, just between June and December.
But all we gotta do is steal from Peter to pay Paul, and then just throw it back in. We don't have to actually go borrow, we just borrow from ourselves.
Peter.
Okay. Alrighty, or somebody wants to make a motion?
I make a motion that we finance the proposed improvements over the elementary at the, we borrow, takes $400,000 out of depreciation fund, $350,000 out of the building fund, for a total of $750,000. We pay it off in 3 years. What side do you wanna go?
I'm sorry, you second?
3 years, no, Kristen.
Kristen.
Okay, it's been approved and seconded. Vicki?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Jason?
Yes.
Kristen?
Yes.
Cam?
Yes.
Motion carries.
Alright, gents, thank you.
Yes, thanks, guys.
So what we're gonna do, you have just a minute, what we're gonna do is we'll start preparing the official statement, and that's the offering document that we have to show potential investors. And it'll be either later this week or the beginning of next week is when we'll actually be in the market. And after we're in the market, we'll send up a bond purchase agreement to the school district. And in that bond purchase agreement, it sets the interest rates and the principal amounts, the payment dates, and anything else that's relevant to the bonds. And then once the school district signs the bond purchase agreement, that in effect executes the order. And then roughly, probably 30 days roughly from now, so the first part of May is when we'll close. That's when the interest starts to accrue, and that's also the same day we'll wire the proceeds to the school district.
So cocktails party that night.
Show us.
I'd like to buy a new purse for her.
Yeah, she's on the shopping over there.
I'm blocked, well, let me in.
But if anytime during the process you have questions, don't hesitate to give us a call.
Excellent, all right.
Appreciate it.
Thanks so much for coming out.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah, safe travels.
Good to see you, thanks.
Thank you, Jay, we'll see you.
Take care.
Safe travels.
Thanks.
Okay, now we're gonna move back to number eight, teaching and learning committee.
I make a motion to move into closed session to discuss personnel and staffing options for next school year.
I'll second.
So move in second to in closed session, discuss personnel for next teaching year. Myself, yes, Jason?
Yes.
Krista?
Yes.
Jan?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Okay, we're just gonna step across, so you guys have to run up to anywhere.
It'll tough to be on call if you don't take your phone with you.
Hey, how is the track me going?
Cold.
The board.
It's still cold.
I think he got first in 1200, Abby White got first in 1200. Boys from Clay got first in 4x1, the girls.
Aww.
Haley got first in the hurdles. I didn't hear much on the back. Oh, we found that. Is that turned off?
Always, you know, what would that be? A lot of that has to do with some income tax loopholes and folks, things that that folks have income tax that they don't have to pay income tax for, maybe closing some of those. 295 is a big one that provides tax credits for private school scholarship donations. So this would take money out of the public school TEOSA funding formula. So if people want to provide, it's essentially a step towards vouchers. Okay, so the public schools are definitely not in favor of that. 778 would limit building fund levies. Anything over 5 cents, you'd need a public vote of approval. Anything over 5 cents, we'd be in that category, obviously.
So even though we're there, we'd have to go back and vote on that?
Well, I don't know when it would be in effect. It would be retroactive, but
okay.
If you're over a nickel already, would you have to, I don't know the specific one. It initially was any building fund would require voter approval, but now they said we'll give you a nickel, anything over a nickel. And again, don't know for sure where that's going to go. And 640, I think, is the governor's priority bill providing property tax relief through reducing the school levy authority. So just trying to find improve the funding mechanism for school districts. Doesn't dramatically affect us because we're not, TEOSA doesn't affect us. We're not an equalized school. Okay, we're at 6 snow days for teachers, 5 snow days for kids. Probably in okay shape, well we are. I mean, we're not in a position where we're short on hours, so we don't have it at this point, any intent to try to make up any days. When I went to NERCSA, those are the things that I attended, the online speech therapy. I'll be darned, we're doing that starting this week. They're just, speech people are not out there. ESU has somebody they send over to monitor our kids who are receiving their speech therapy on a computer. Certainly less than ideal, but if there's nobody, you know, a person, you know, so I don't know if that, Idaho is where they might be getting their speech therapy. Building CTE Alliance, Career Tech Alliances with Rural Nebraska Schools, that, I shared that with you. Sped updates, always interesting. Summer, best practices in summer reading programs, ours is kind of simple enough. This was a much more cumbersome summer reading program. Ours is what we do, it just, I think, fits our needs really pretty well. And then always sessions on school safety. We had our evacuation drill, I thought I had it up.
Yeah, second one.
Sorry. Oh, there, it's not supposed to be, there should be a dark one. That, I think, went pretty well, simple. We didn't do a, let's sweep the building for a bomb, or let's sweep the building for an intruder, or let's, it was well-managed, like it would be if we said, all right, we need to get everybody out kind of hastily versus intruder in the building, which is every teacher kind of been in position to make their own decisions of whether they're gonna run, whether they're gonna stay. But also, sure enough, you know, we've seen lately, you see in the news, the school district has a bucket of rocks in every classroom. Well, we're not completely off the mark here. And Jolene Palmer, who's in charge of school safety, at this session I went to, she mentioned wasp spray. Now, our guy might have got it from, they both heard from the same places. I had somebody say, wasp spray? You need bear spray. He was serious, not gonna mention any names, Bruce Curtis, but he was, his point was, this will incapacitate a person. You shoot somebody with that, they're going down. Wasp spray, they're maybe not going down, but I wouldn't want to get hit with either one, but we're probably not gonna replace our wasp spray with bear spray, but anyway, I appreciate the suggestion.
Kids try out the rocks, if you throw them.
They were waiting for you to come through. You see Mike come through, up the rocks and.
He's really curious about how this will work. So, at any rate, I mean, we're probably doing the best we can. We'll take the evacuation a step further next time, and maybe involve local and county law enforcement, maybe they can come and familiarize themselves with our building, whatever, but.
So where did you go?
We went to the city, if you're on this side of Woodland Avenue, you go to the city, chamber office. If you're on that side of Woodland Avenue, you're gonna go to the library. So practically all the elementary, the ag shop, if we've got kids down the track for something, whatever, like that would seem. Just essentially we're saying Woodland Avenue is split. So that was that.
All right, anybody have anything else for? All right.
Thank you, I appreciate your understanding. Ms. Levicki?
Don't speak.
You can speak for me.
Well, you did give me time to buy a purse, so thanks a lot.
I'll be contacting you about signatures, mainly Kristen and Mike.
Can I leave those down your office?
Please leave those with Kelly.
She gonna stick around until we get inside? All right, we can shut the door when we get down there.
Or you can bring him in tomorrow.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, where are we at?
Who knows?
Number ten, is that the next one?
Ten would be next, yes.
Number ten, discuss and take possible action on offering certified contracts for 2018-2019. Like Dr. Arl said, it's just a formality that we do, they roll over, so I don't know if there's any discussion or anything, it's just a matter of voting on it. So, yes, some discussion. I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve offering certified teaching and extra duty contracts for 2018-2019.
Second.
I'll second.
First and second, Jan?
Yes.
Krista?
Yes.
Jason?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Vicki?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Motion carries. Yeah, number 11, discuss and take possible action on setting classified salaries for 2018-2019. You guys want to talk about it, or you just want to table it?
Just in table it.
Table it, okay, we'll table that until next month.
You need a motion.
Table, I don't think we did motion to table. I don't think we did last month. Table it this month. Number 12, discuss and take possible action on accepting Abby Cush's resignation. We all got that resignation in our packets.
I'll make a motion to approve the resignation of Abby Cush with regret.
Second?
Second.
First and second. Myself, yes. Vicki?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Jan?
Yes.
Krista?
Yes.
Jason?
Yes.
Motion carries. Okay, we're down to activities reports, I believe. I'm going to hear from that. We've got
that stuff.
Lots going on.
Golf track.
Do you need any more, Patty, or you, they keep you busy with all this stuff, activities?
And that's, yeah, look at the calendar, plus you should see mine in here. I know everybody else says, can't wait till basketball gets over, things settle down. This is the worst time of year.
Okay, principal's report, we've been waiting all night for.
Okay, well, most of this you can read, and most of it you've already read in the papers, because by the time I give it to you, it's already been all read. And on Twitter and every other form of social media. I do want you to note the first one, they took the ACT on April 3rd. I'm just really disappointed in the Department of Ed for doing that. The kids worked really hard while we were down there, you know, but I think we kind of set them up for failure, because you have them do it after a 4-day break, and then you come in here with a late start. And you had to, if you had school, you had to test, regardless of what time, as long as you could get them started by 10:30. And we did all of those things, and had they not taken the test, we'd already spent an hour filling out just the pre-stuff to take the ACT. That all had to go back. Everything had to be tabulated, accounted for. You have to actually take every booklet, write the number down, what kid it corresponds with. It's a nightmare to fill out and try to keep track and make sure that, and then when they're sitting in the room, we have to go through and tabulate who's sitting exactly where, what book they have, how long they tested. It is not fun for them, but they worked hard. I think they tried. They took the entire time. It's not like anybody rushed through it and got done and just sat there. So, you know, it is what it is at this point, and I think they took it pretty serious. We were having pizza when it was over, but that kind of got messed up, because that would have meant they didn't eat lunch until 3:30. You can't do that. They get, and they honestly get 15 minutes of break in that. And so I had it out in the other part, and the library works really well with us. It's a great place to have it, so we're very fortunate that we have that spot. So all in all, I don't know how they did academically. I just know that they were a pretty easy group to work with. Everybody was on time, unlike last year. I had too late.
Do they take questions and comments at the state level about how it went?
Well, they do, but they don't read them, and they don't care, no. Otherwise, why would you have done that? Because we all told them. The day after he's there. Scholastic contest was March 21st. We had several kids that received first place. They were all listed in the paper. Our Miles of Smiles was here again, and it was probably a good thing, because we never were able to reschedule the kindergarten trip to Dr. Mike's. We just had snow day, good start, nothing seemed to work. So that's a very good program. We are looking at, know how much you pay attention to what's going on with standards and those things. Their recommendation this next year is that you don't buy textbooks, that you just go and use their provided resources. I think that's a terrible idea, and I think most of my teachers thought that was a terrible idea. We budget for, by the way, thanks for that, because if you're watching the news, some of these people have textbooks older than me, so not quite, but so we are going to look at adopting this series, K-5. I met with the science people. I don't know that parents are ready for no resources. You know, we have a lot of kids that go home to nobody anyway. And when they're trying to figure out what they're supposed to do, I just think if you have that textbook for a reference, it just makes things easier. So we're going to look at going all the way through ninth grade. And this one is a K-5. And it matches somewhat of the standards, because they're moving to a more hands-on type program, and they're going to bring in all the resources. Plus, your new teachers, I think of how devastating that is for them. Here you go. Now, go find all of this stuff on your own. Here's some things, but I don't think that's a good idea. So we're going to stay the course.
And so you move up as the kids move up. You buy the first section out, and then when they get to sixth grade?
No, this will be a K-5 program, like we did reading.
Oh, I thought you said you're going through ninth grade.
We are. This one is K-5, but they don't make a 6-9 program. So Robin's going to help me try to find that one. Because actually what they're doing is, you know, one grade takes a life science, one takes earth science, one takes physical science. You have to teach all three in 1 year, so trying to find a textbook written to the middle row with all three of them in there is what we have to look for. Because we don't want to buy three different textbooks, so that's what we discussed. Kindergarten preschool roundup is April 20th. Right now we have 13.
You have the 12th in here.
12. What did I say?
20.
It's the 12th. It's Thursday. Where did I get the 20th? Huh. Anyway, it's the 12th. It's Thursday. We have 13 preschoolers and about 23 and 23, kindergarten, 23, first grade. That's about where we're at. So I'm just kind of giving you a heads up. I may look at that, and not may, I'm going to pull the kids in that class and try to determine, would it be more beneficial to go to kindergarten or to first grade based on the needs of the kids. And right now it's looking like first grade might have the most need.
I think you have to look at it. You can't just go by numbers. You got to look at the
we
needs.
Have, yeah. It's literally like this. You have kids here and kids up here. And you have kids all over the room. In kindergarten right now, so I'm not sure that we want to shove all of those kids, and it's not a lot. It's a maintainable number, but if we want to do justice for primary grades, one of those needs to be split, and I'm not so sure that we need kindergarten. You put a full-time para in there if you don't have a lot of kids that needs, and in kindergarten, in first grade next year, we'll have two that right now have paras working full-time. So that's where we're going with that. NERCSA. Lord, I can't even read. NSCAS is the new testing system, and that's going to start at the end of the week for elementary. High school is next week. And this is my plug for Mr. Souser not being a teacher and just can work on this stuff. I literally watched hours and hours and hours of webinars trying to figure out how to get these kids in here. I could see my kids. I went to print tickets, couldn't figure it out. And I watched and watched again. And Red couldn't figure it out. He sits down for an hour and has it all done and helps me get everybody in. So we have started registration. We still have a lot of unknowns, which makes it difficult, such as AD and all of those things will affect when teachers can teach, who's coaching junior high. Yeah. And we can film as coaches in-house. Speech, we're district champs. We had 3 first place winners. Can't really. I know the OID got cards today from Ben Sass.
Really?
That was kind of cool. But Els didn't get one, so we'll go faster.
Oh, it came to me.
Els did?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's happening.
Okay, good. Because I put those in their locker and they started reading them, and she was the only one that didn't get first. You know, she got first and didn't get one, so I was a little concerned. That same Friday, we had 3 little darlings that had to leave the speech team and go to the music thing, and it happens every year. Austin, Becca, Brittany, and then Rosemary came down with her, and they stayed for Allstate Music. Tractor Parade and Jazzercise held their annual fundraising events, and we did win Relay for Life again. I just got an email from Renita looking for a day to celebrate. So they won it again. It's about 5 years in a row. Art show is April 6th and 7th, over, of course, prom, April 7th. Commend our kids. They do a fabulous job if you see them. Obviously, we didn't have any issues at prom. And when we got here, Mike, you could probably attest to this because you were here. Trent and Carly both are in knee braces. They're supposed to walk in. And whatever side they were supposed to be on, they couldn't walk the appropriate way because their knee braces would climb into each other. I said, they're supposed to be on the other side. She can't. Her braces don't work that way. And so, obviously, they didn't get to dance either. And when they got here, Ann Dowd said that she noticed that Trent didn't have anything in his tubs because they buy huge tubs for these kids, which is really nice. They go put their things in there. And so Jacob Hoffman started playing games for him, and then our kids just started donating things to his tub. So he probably walked away the biggest winner of all. So I thought that was kind of a nice thing to do because, you know, some of them, it's not that big a deal. You get the TVs, it's a big deal. I don't know who got those. She had TVs, refrigerators. I told John to try for the vacuum. I said, do you even know what that is? No, he didn't know. So, in our post-prom, people did an amazing job. They had the hypnotist, and you, then what'd you do after that? Oh, escape rooms, right?
Escape rooms and the hypnotist, and they...
And then they played their normal games that they play and had food galore and...
So they ate down at a restaurant, and then they came back here right after that?
Yep.
And had to dance and...
Yeah.
And they had to dance down there.
Yeah, we danced down there too. So that way we don't, they can set up here. It just works so nice.
So they didn't decorate here at all, then?
Nope.
Did they decorate down there?
Yeah.
Yeah, and they don't decorate a lot anymore. I don't know that you need to waste all of that money and spend thousands of dollars decorating. They danced and they had a great time. They danced for about 3.5 hours. We paid the guy extra money so they could dance, and they did. So.
Good.
Very nice.
Did your ankle hold up?
What?
Did your ankle hold up with all the dancing?
It did. It did. I was more concerned about John trying to do some of those dances because you can't do that. He thinks he can and refused to wear a brace, so whatever. I don't know anything. State FFA and FCCLA, actually they're going today for FCCLA. State FFA, we had 9 seniors earn state degrees. And I know Austin placed 3rd and Elizabeth 4th in whatever area they were giving speeches in. Chad was telling me, but it was Saturday night and it was 1 o'clock in the morning. I wasn't fully listening. And district music is April 20th in Osmond. I haven't seen much information. Their concert, though, is the 17th at 7-ish, I do believe, and that's their pre-contest concert.
Glad to know that because I haven't heard that yet.
We do know that for now. And elementary is the 30th. Oh boy, track and golf have started officially. Unofficially, they haven't competed too much because everything's just been miserable. And there was a whole god more things that I could have put on there. I just decided to put a calendar in there for you so you can reference that.
A lot going on.
Because there are a lot of things. The 10th, I don't think this is on there because this was kind of a late addition. Tomorrow night we have a library night for our title program. And for, it's library week, and so they're going to combine and do some activities over in the elementary. They're going to do those escape rooms and... I think those are kind of cool. Are they not, Mike? Did you see them?
Did I see them?
You didn't see any of them? Well, you have to go in and get clues to get out of this room, and you have to figure it out, and then you have to figure which one to go next. And
you couldn't touch anything on the teacher's desk. There's clues hidden in the room, and you got to figure that out.
Hmm. It's not like it's dark and they set obstacles up. You have to figure out the clues to get out. I heard the 80s one was really difficult.
If they did that on Big Bang Theory.
Yeah, they do. And actually, it's a big big money maker. You could start a business if you don't have anything else to do. I got an email from a guy, $2,500 for 2 hours to come out and do that with your staff.
So who set it all up and figured out all the clues?
Paula did some, Ann did some, and I don't know who else, but they put a lot of time into post-prom. And I'm just going to say I kind of like it better when they are here instead of going to the Y. Kind of like our kids in town. I think they had a great time. I didn't hear any kids say, other than they were tired, which is your typical whatever's going on. Okay, that's all I have, by the way. Sorry, I forgot.
Is there anything on here we've forgotten? Or?
Did you do the teaching and learning committee?
That was what they were doing.
What's that?
Oh, sorry, I missed that.
Yeah, okay. All right. President's report. Gee, thanks, guys. You didn't notice that.
Got it all.
I just want to congratulate Mr. Schindler and Mrs. Mosel and all your work and students. Job well done. So.
Way to go out with a bang.
Yeah.
We want to thank you too for all
your years. Since you're out of
time. I've been watching you for many years, and it's always been fun and exciting.
You will be missed.
Yeah, you will.
It's been a good journey.
I like that room you have up there with all your pictures and stuff. I just don't like where it's at. I wish it was down here where people could see it.
I have thought about requesting that.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know where we're going to put it, but it'd be nice if people could see it.
Yeah.
There's a lot of honors up there.
There's a lot of
history.
Yes. Yeah. A lot of about this hallway down here.
Maybe on the entranceway where they use this side door.
Mm-hmm. thought, but congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, we're adjourned.
This is for you to sign.
Okay.
Did you start signing?
No, I left the address, there's no place for me to sign.
So excited. It worked, they weren't, and I didn't have to, so, we're gonna go with the entry way of $30,990.
Oh, you locked up?
And then the classroom will be $39,925.
Please don't make me turn the lights off.
I can show you how to run that.
I know. I don't think it will work.
Spent a lot of money, didn't need a lot of time doing it.
Yes, she was.
Take you longer.
This may not be the time, this take me spin, a lot longer than.
So you got the papers to sign in, Michael?
Yes.